We used to have to eat everything on our plates. My father would scream at me. He's like, you fucking eat everything on your plate. Eat everything on your plate! I'm like, why are you yelling and why is that a rule? Why can't I just put it back? You know what he said? Because people are starving in India. So I overate till I was 18. Then I met somebody from India. And I was like, what the fuck is going on in your country? Do you know that I've been nervously shoveling food into my stupid face for 2 decades because apparently you guys can't get your shit together? Newsflash, everybody. Indian people have food. It's called Indian food. If they're starving, it says Indian food is too hot to eat. Have you ever had Indian food? Holy shit. Every once in a while, I take a cab in New York. I always know it's an Indian driver because it's the same song on the radio. And the song sounds like this. Then I realize that's not a song. That's a guy who just ate Indian food. That's how hot Indian food is. And it's pungent. If you leave Indian food out overnight, the next day, you have to move. That's why Indian people are in this country. They left Indian food out in India. They're like, we have to move to the next town, to the next continent. We need to put an ocean between ourselves and this smell. This smells like somebody's trying to avenge the death of their brother. Indian food. I'm middle-aged. I go to my doctor. He's like, Mike, you need more exercise. I'm like, no, Indian food. He's like, no, you need to sweat and get your heart rate up. I'm like, that's exactly what Indian food does. You throw in a touch of diarrhea, you've nailed it completely. Indian food. And when some people hear these jokes, they're like, Mike, are you racist against Indian people? I'm like, absolutely not. I love Indian people, because I live in Queens. And when it's 3 o'clock in the morning and I need beer, cigarettes, beef jerky, and perhaps a scratch-off ticket, guess who's there for me? I'll give you a hint, it's none of you white motherfuckers. It's an Indian guy. He's there, he's smiling, he's wearing sandals in any kind of weather. Then after you live the lifestyle for 20 years, beer, cigarettes, and beef jerky, and you need open heart surgery, guess who walks into the room? Yeah, a fucking nice Dr. Patel. That's what I love about Indians. They tear you down, but then they build you back up again. Indians, this message was brought to you by Indians. A couple more minutes, we'll get right into my Pakistani chunk.